is communication. It's the exchange of information, conveying and sharing of ideas, isn't it? I'm communicating an idea to you right now. What makes this possible? Connections, the internet. Do trees have a similar system? Do trees communicate? How? Let's find out. A forest is an area dominated by trees. But that's not it. A forest is not just a collection of trees, but a connection of trees, and it behaves like one single organism. The credit of this breakthrough goes to Suzanne Simmard. She grew replicates of fir, birch, and cedar. She covered these in plastic bags. In the birch bags, she added carbon dioxide with the radioactive carbon-14 isotope. And in the fir bags, she added the stable carbon-13 isotope. After an hour, she used her Geiger counter, which detects radioactivity. She ran it over the birch leaves, and like we expect, it beeped. When she ran it over the fir needles, it beeped again, which means that in some way, the birch had sent its radioactive carbon to the fir, which means that these two were communicating. How did the plants do this?
All the tree roots in a forest have a symbiotic association with fungi. This is called mycorrhiza. Trees photosynthesize sugars, and in return, the fungi send their mycelium all through the soil to transport nutrients and water from tree to tree. The mycorrhizal network, called the wood wide web, integrates numerous plant species. The mycorrhizal network increases the net rate of photosynthesis. It improves seed survival and also increases the resistance to pathogens. The donor plant is generally nutrient-rich, older, larger, and may have greater access to sunlight. Older mother trees supply nutrients to their seedlings, and cutting them weakens the young ones. Trees can also warn others of danger. For example, the acacia trees have developed clever mechanisms to prevent giraffes from eating them. The tree releases ethylene gas through its leaf pores. Other acacias within 150 feet detect this warning and secrete tannins. Tannins are bitter carbon-based compounds. They inhibit digestion by interfering with protein and digestive enzymes. This makes consumed leaves difficult to digest and hence drives the giraffe away.
For generations, we believed trees to be competing disconnected hermits. Today we know that they're cooperating connected organisms. This groundbreaking revelation has far-reaching implications. This changes our approach towards forests. It opens doors to create and conserve strong, resilient forests. I hope this helped you relate and understand trees a little better. I'm Ekta. Thanks for watching.